let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. And thank God for all that he's done for us. Thank him for his salvation. Oh, thank him for his leading and his guidance. Oh, thank him with great joy for you in his heart, in his presence. Come on, put your hands together. Faithfulness. chasing after you, Lord. I am pressing to a higher calling, and you are making all things new. Yes, you are making all things new. I am forgetting what lies behind me. I'm chasing after you. Yes, I am chasing after you. Sunday we'll be gathering and praying from our homes together in the spirit in one accord throughout the day. This morning, let us open our Bibles and go to Psalm 32. What is the psalm that says in verse 6, "For this cause, everyone who's godly shall pray to you in a time when you may be found." And we are the ones who seek God, and we want God in our lives. That's what it means to be godly. Our eyes are set on Him, and we will follow Him, and we'll spend time praying unto Him. That is why we've come to this house this morning, and He has done wonderful and marvelous things. And each and every one who accepted Jesus Christ, who followed the Lord Jesus Christ, this psalm begins by saying, "Blessed are each and every one of you, for your transgression is forgiven. Blessed are you, for the Lord has not imputed iniquity, for He finds no deceit in those whose heart and spirit are set on the right path. And you opened your mouths and confessed your sin, and He has forgiven you, and He's delivered you, and He brought you and given you a new life." Hallelujah. And He will continue to instruct and teach you. You know, this week, as verse 8 onwards, it says, "I will instruct you and teach you the way you should go. I'll guide you with my eye." You're going to have a spiritual upliftment. You're going to go from strength to strength. Even as we sang from glory to glory, you're going to draw closer to God throughout this week. As you spend time, at least an hour each day, praying together with the church. Therefore, let us read this psalm and let it speak to you. And let God be glorified, for all the word of God, the entire Bible, has been given by divine inspiration. And as you read it, there is a transformation that takes place. Even if you do not understand, as you read it, God will touch and transform you. Therefore, this morning, join along as we read this Psalm 32 from verse 1 to the end of the chapter. From verse 1, together as Lord as He can, each and every one of you say, "Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is a man to whom the Lord does not impute iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no deceit. When I kept silent, my bones grew old through my groaning all the day long. For day and night your hand was heavy upon me. My vitality was turned into the drought of summer. Shall I acknowledge my sin to you, and my iniquity I have not hidden? I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and He forgave the iniquity of my sin. For this cause, everyone who is godly shall pray to you in a time when you may be found. Surely in a flood of great waters, they shall not come near him. You are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from trouble. You shall surround me with songs of deliverance. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will guide you with my eye. Do not be like the horse or like the mule, which have no understanding, which must be harnessed with bit and bridle, else they will not come near you. Many sorrows shall be to the wicked, but he who trusts in the Lord, mercy shall surround him. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, you righteous, and shout for joy, all your upright in heart. Oh, you've set your heart on the right path to follow the Lord and to do what is right. Therefore be glad, therefore rejoice, therefore shout for joy, for you've been made righteous by Christ Jesus. You got to find a reason every time to praise and worship God for those who find it difficult. I want to tell you and encourage you to be glad, because when you've accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, all that is from your past is taken away, and now you're righteous like Him. Therefore be glad, for you're accepted in His eyes, and you are the chosen ones in the world, and He has a special gift and special love, special grace, special mercy. Oh, and He will lead you as a shepherd among all the people of the world, and you are the highly favored of God. Therefore this morning shout for joy and be glad in His house, in His presence. Oh, join along. Call of the Lord, the ones who are going to be taken to heaven. Join along this morning. Oh, even right now.
Everything for us, for you held nothing back. Open the heavens wide, open his heart wide, open his arms wide, and died on the cross for each and every one of you. If we come unto him this morning once again, that has opened him and look unto him. Thank you.
tell them we look. We look.
From the dead is present this morning in our mess. The Holy Spirit of God. John Long said, let now the weak say I have strength by the Spirit of
you.
Oh, what a marvelous, wonderful, glorious presence of God. Oh, it's in this house this morning, it's glory. Yeah. Whoa. Oh, just take some time to enjoy His presence this morning. Oh.
Supernatural power. The ones who are delivered and been set free. And even as we come thus far, God has led us. And in this week, we're going to pray for the last seventh phase that this nation is going to face in election. Not just for that, but for the next 4 years, for the future of this nation. The people find hope. they'll experience the love of God, the true love of God, not a dead religion of man and the devil, but every lie and deception of the devil and every evil unclean spirit will be struck down this morning. They'll hear the name of Jesus. They'll feel the wonderful presence of God in every state in this nation, in every city, in every town, in every district, in every village. The good news be heard. That's why we join together, not miss a single opportunity to serve the Lord, to exalt Him in this nation, to keep the fire burning. The darkness would not increase, but the light, the only thing that will increase. Oh, that's even this morning. We're going to stand together as one church, one body. The followers of Jesus Christ as soldiers in His army. And strike down every lie, every evil, every opposition, every hindrance, every barrier to all the people in this nation coming unto the Lord Jesus Christ and making their way to heaven through Him. They'll put a stop to them going to hell. The deception in this nation would stop. If on behalf of them, we're going to lift up a voice for those who have no voice. We're going to stand up for those who cannot stand up. But we're going to intercede this morning. And we're going to tear down the devil's kingdom. Oh, are you ready this morning? We've been deceived by the devil too long. We're gonna tear the devil's kingdom down. What he said was his, has been ours all along. And this day we're gonna tear the devil's kingdom down.
The high.
kingdom down. Whose report will you believe? Said we shall believe the report of the Lord. Everybody, whose report will you believe? We shall believe the report of the Lord. Tell me, whose report will you believe? Shout and say, we shall believe the report of the Lord. Whose report will you believe? We shall believe the report of the Lord. Jesus Christ has said, you will trample serpents and scorpions, and no power will be able to stand against you all the days of your life, and nothing will hurt or harm you. Oh, therefore this morning, take all that belongs to you.
Stop!
died on the cross to get back to you, to give back to you, for you to have it. Never lose it, even one day or one moment. Starting with that state of being, that salvation, with that body that He has given you, to be in that state of healing, and health and life flowing through it. A mind that is renewed, refreshed, and your life completely being transformed to be that new creation. You're different from the rest of the world. To them you might look the same, but you are a new creation, created by God, and supernatural things will always happen in your life. Oh, therefore this morning, with a grateful heart, oh, come unto Him, for He's touched you, He's changed you. Oh, ask God, say, oh Lord, hold me close, draw me to your side, that I might rise like an eagle.
Lord, I come to you, let my heart be changed, renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you. Lord, I've come to know the weaknesses I see in me will be stripped away by the power.
possible. It's because of your love. Come unto the Lord Jesus Christ this morning with all love. Adoration with great expectation. So get ready to tap out the table of the Lord. Prepare your hearts and your minds. Let the blood of Jesus purify and cleanse each and every one who are here. So get ready to receive from Him. Let His words transform you and prepare you. The Lord Jesus Christ said in John chapter 6 verse 35 onwards, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. The bread that I shall give is my flesh, which I shall give for the life of the world. Most assuredly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink His blood, you have no life in you. Who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. As the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so he who feeds on me will live because of me. Each and every one of you, come with love, with expectation, with faith. Come forward this morning unto the Lord Jesus Christ and take part in Him.